Then he staggered home, back to the tent, appeared there in the entrance with earth and mud around his eyes, worms crawling out of his ears, beetles in his hair. He said to his father, three times. Three times you've tried to kill me. You pushed me into the bear's den, but the bears welcomed me. You pushed me into the lake, but the fish helped me. You buried me in the earth, but still I did not die. Now it's time for you to come into the forest with us as I went with you. He and his wife, the forest woman, they led the priest into the forest to a clearing. And the forest woman called the beasts, fox, wolf, bear, lynx. They came and they formed a circle around the old man, growling and pawing at the ground.
Quahti, poras piirehti etni ja ähti heillä attentit ja tein liemaa ja nälläsi. Quahti, quahti, poras piire, quahti.
She says, little man, you cannot own me any more than you can own the wind as it blows through the leaves, the rain as it falls on the forest floor. I am made of stories that began before your ancestors stepped onto this land. Glaciers carved my body from rock. The stone spirit sang me into being. The sun gave birth to me. My skin is thin and feels like birch. I sweat fine sap. My roots split the earth's core and I breathe out the sky.
Worthy.
Gave the signal.
Worthy.
And the beast leapt on him and they tore him. They took that stinking bed from the corner of the tent outside and they burnt it. They opened the flaps of the tent so the air could blow through. They cleaned and scrubbed everything until it was new. And then they began their life together as husband and wife. And as long as he remembered who she was, they lived happily.